Josef Fares and the team at Hazelight Studio, makers of 2018's fantastic A Way Out, have a very different view of what a cooperative game should be like. And their latest, It Takes Two, is shaping up to continue pioneering this new breed of co-op-only adventure games. And in the process, they might even bring a pair of former lovers back together. It Takes Two is a cooperative-only action-adventure platformer, but even to leave it at just that wordy description is doing the game a disservice. Much like A Way Out, It Takes Two largely adopts the genre of whatever the story calls for. In the first level of my demo that I got to play with Josef Fares himself, things began very traditionally with the two characters, Cody and May, a divorced couple that get transformed into dolls by a magical book of love, awakening in a workshop shed. With Josef taking control of May and me guiding Cody, we had to make our way through the shed, hopping over boxes, and chasing after a runaway fuse using all the familiar 3D platformer fundamentals. Double jumps, wall jumps, butt stomps, and so on. The platforming itself controls well and the challenges are pretty straightforward, but where It Takes Two really shines is when it introduces segments that require coordination and cooperation between the two players. A real standout is the latter half of the first level, where May grabs a hammer while Cody grabs a nail. As you can see, each tool has its own specific use, creating a fun dynamic that could probably be further developed into its own co-op puzzle platformer game, but here it's just a small slice of a larger cake that you just eat a quick bite of and then move on to the next one. Another fun genre shift is when Cody and May get wrapped up in a war between squirrels and wasps and are outfitted with a pair of complementary guns. Much like the hammer and nail segment, there's a really fun process of each character having to figure out what their tool is capable of, communicating that with their partner, and then coming up with a way to figure out how to use the tools in tandem in order to find a way out of the room. The demo wrapped up with an exciting chase that had May in the gunner seat of a plane as Cody piloted their way out of the Wasp's headquarters. Once again, it was a segment that relied on careful coordination as the gunner had to not only fend off enemy planes, but also had to clear a path for the pilot by burning down barriers that blocked off an escape route. And if that wasn't enough, the level concludes with an epic fight against the squirrel commander atop a plane in the style of a 2D fighting game, which filled me with all kinds of jealousy as I was relegated to piloting the plane while Josef got to style on this poor squirrel. If you ever get to a point where you just want to have it out with your co-op buddy, like maybe after they lock you in a torture box and don't let you out, much like in A Way Out, there are a number of competitive minigames that you can face off against each other in. The one that I got to play was a variation of Whack-A-Mole, where I was the mole and got points for keeping my head up, while my partner got points every time they managed to whack me. It was a lot of fun, and I got to make Josef sweat because even though he beat me, it was only by 1 point in a come-from-behind win. All in all, It Takes Two is shaping up to be exactly the kind of follow-up to A Way Out that I was hoping it would be. By designing a game that is uncompromisingly intended to be played with two players and two players only, Hazelight is able to play with co-op mechanics in ways that haven't really been explored in any other game quite like this. Thankfully, it will also come with a friend pass system that allows a player who owns the game to invite someone to play with them regardless of whether they own the game or not. So, start thinking about who the Cody to your May will be, or vice versa, because It Takes Two will hit PlayStation 4, PlayStation 5, Xbox One, Xbox Series X, S, and PCs on March 26th. Thanks for watching, and for everything else, keep it here on IGN.